Hello friends, I am the Travelers Nayak. I welcome all of you to this MOOC on Academic Counseling for ODL Learners. In this video, we shall discuss the different factors responsible for the disadvantageous position of the people with disabilities. Access to inclusive education is based upon four principles: presence, participation, acceptance, and achievement. 15% of people across the world, they suffer from one form or another form of disability. Some people are born with disabilities and some people get disabled due to factors beyond their control. The percentage of people with disabilities going for higher education is very, very negligible. In India, it is as negligible as 0.56%. Our society is constructed by people with capabilities for people with capabilities. This system makes the people with impairments incapable of functioning. Apathy of the common people towards the people with disabilities, inadequate accessibility of higher educational institutions, inappropriate teaching methods, inappropriate admission and application procedures, inadequate resources and support services, low financial capacity, and the non-supportive political will contribute to the disadvantageous position of people with disabilities. The needs of people with disabilities are identified late. The support staff dealing with the people with disabilities are not properly trained to respond to their needs. Hence, the people with disabilities, they hesitate to approach such staff for any support for the fear of being discriminated or victimized. People who are disabled, they feel more disadvantaged when the people around them don't respond to their needs. Now, let us discuss the different factors which contribute to the disadvantageous position of the people with disabilities. First of all, physical infrastructure. Inaccessible physical infrastructure is the greatest challenge faced by people with disabilities. When people with disabilities don't find sidewalks for the wheelchair users, the multi-storied buildings don't have elevators and ramps, the doorknobs are too high, and the doors are too narrow, they find it very difficult to move around. When the transport system is inaccessible, these people with disabilities, they remain confined to their homes and they cannot attend routine social academic activities. Now let us discuss the second factor that contributes to their disadvantageous position. That is the unfriendly environment and negative attitude. Attitudes of people with disabilities and without disabilities towards disability determines the position or status of the people with disabilities in the society. Negative attitudes of the academic and administrative staff and peers, they force the differently abled people to resign to their own conditions and hide their invisible disabilities. They don't request anyone to accommodate their interests. People dealing with their PWDs, they must ensure that the rights and policies for the PWDs are implemented in word and spirit. Challenges to access to education for the people with disabilities start right from their family level, because the family members, they consider it a wastage of time to send their children with disability to school. Moreover, sometimes the breadwinner of a family is required to dedicate himself or herself to the service of the differently abled child. This adversely affects their family income. When the differently abled people consider their disability to be a burden and they don't take any step to come out of this disabling environment, their condition deteriorates and people around them, they start victimizing them. Negative attitudes of people towards people with disabilities develop when people are not sensitive to their problems and nor know their rights. Such people, they never try to accommodate the interests of the people with disabilities. Now let us go to the next factor that determines the condition of the people with disabilities. That is gender. Gender, in case of women, this disability becomes a double handicap. First of all, they are disabled because of their gender, which the society considers to be inferior to men. On the other hand, when they are physically challenged, when they are disabled, they are considered to be a double burden by their family and the society. As per the UNICEF report, literacy rates for women are estimated only 1%. Now let us come to the next factor that contributes to the disadvantageous position of the people with disabilities. That is lack of information in accessible formats. Lack of information in accessible formats is an environmental barrier that most of the people with disabilities face, because this prevents them from using the information or services available to the common public. People with visual impairment, for example, they would find the information more acceptable, more useful if it is offered to them in braille or large print. All information and media, they should be available in different formats so that they are useful to the people with disability. And lastly, all the information, all the online and offline support services to the different disabled people should be provided in time so that their participation can be maximized and their performance can be improved. Now let us come to the next factor that contributes to their disadvantageous position. That is public policies. Public policies, they play a very important role in shaping the life of people with disabilities. When the public policies are in support of the people with disabilities, the attitude of the people in the society towards the people with disabilities, it improves. Unless the public policies are very clear about the facilities being given to the people with disabilities, society cannot be expected to have a positive attitude towards these people. Admission policies of the universities can have a disabling or enabling impact upon the learners, depending upon the concessions being given to the people with disabilities. And finally, the last factor, that is lack of appropriate technology. The people with disabilities can be helped in multiple ways by integrating the appropriate technology with the instructional strategies. For example, people with mild visual impairment can be given the presentations large font, and the people with major visual impairment can be helped with the software like JAWS, NVDA, Supernova or Windows Eyes. Likewise, people with hearing impairment can be given presentations and videos in sign language so that they will be able to make use of them. Thank you very much for watching the video, and watch the next video, please. Thank you very much.